Hey, you guys, welcome to this week's vlog. We're gonna do some playtester picks. I'm Michelle, I'm gonna start us off. The Tennis Warehouse backpack has been my absolute favorite. I have been carrying it every day to work, and this is my first pick, but then I'm gonna go into a couple other things that I have been hitting with a bunch on the court. The Head Prestige Pro. I know this came out a little while ago, but I've been playing with it a bunch, hoping that maybe there might be an update coming soon, but it just reminds me of how much I love the controlled power I get out of this racket, plus the cosmetics, great. Strong with Links Tour, you can't lose. Then my third item is gonna be the Adidas Barricade shoes. I have been wearing these for a solid month, and the more I wear them, the more I love them. So they're super stable, they're proving to be very durable, plus they look great on the court, and they fit to my feet awesome right now. So that's all from me. Let's check in with the rest of the playtest team.
Hey, what's up everyone? For my playtester picks today, first thing got going here is some footwear, the ASICS Solution Speed FF2. This is my favorite lightweight shoe on the market. Not necessarily surprising because I'm a big fan of the gel resolutions. Those are super stable, durable, good comfort. These I also find really good comfort. So for a lightweight shoe, there's actually some decent cushion in the midsole there. And I just love the way they contour to my feet. Super comfortable, and just gives me a little more pep in my step, a little more speed when I'm moving around the court. So I really like the FF2 Solution Speed there from ASICS. And then next up for racket, this is in addition to the Pro Staff line. This is the 6-1 100 here. First time hitting with this racket, I was a little confused just because I used a 6195 for so many years and just used to that really beefy weight, swing weight. And with the 100 square inch head size, I was a little skeptical. I was like, this ain't really a 6-1, is it? And then the more I hit with it, I really found the 6-1 feel in this racket, just with a much more forgiving playability, bigger sweet spot. Really maneuverable, really easy to use for a 6-1. I definitely would be adding some weight to this to get the swing weight up a bit and tail weight the racket, but I really like that the 6-1 feels there. Nice, firm, crisp, easy pop, easy spin. Just a really nice racket from Wilson, and really digging this one lately. And then lastly, for my bag here, I got the Tennis Warehouse duffel. I know Michelle has the nice backpack, but I carry way more stuff than Michelle when I come to work, from a change of clothes to my rackets, shoes. All the toiletries and everything fits in here. I think it's a really cool looking bag, and compares to like a Technifiber rack pack, but just a much better value. So super sweet bag there, and that's my picks for today.
Hey guys, Brady here, and some of my top picks for this week starts off with the Babolat Pure Drive 2018 Wimbledon Edition. Now this is the previous model, the blue with the black and white. And this Wimbledon Edition is beautiful with this purple color, one of my favorite colors, and has some call outs to Wimbledon on the frame. The Pure Drive is one of my favorite rackets. It'll be in my top three before, and it will be in my top three in the future. And I just love it. It has easy access to power, spin, depth, really easy to swing, and just a great easy racket to use, perfect for my game. It's also at a great price of $159 right now. Secondly is the Nike Gym Duffel Bag. Now this is a smaller duffel bag. It won't hold a racket, but it'll hold a lot of other gear, extra change of clothes, accessories. It has a couple accessory pockets inside and outside. It's perfect for me, a mom on the go. I can take it from work to the gym to the tennis court without any issues. And my third pick is one of my tried and true favorites, the Adidas Stella Court Shoe. Now this shoe does everything right for me. It is lightweight, so I feel really fast on the court. There's plenty of cushioning underneath, and it's nice and stable and solid, so my ankles feel locked in. That's it for me. Now I'm gonna pass it to Tiff.
Hi guys, last but not least, but definitely shortest, fun fact, had to drop the camera for me. With my picks is Tiffany, and I'm gonna start off with a Nike skirt. Love the club skirt, and this is new for fall, and this is the striped edition. What I really love about the club skirt is actually something that you can't see unless it's tucking the ball in, is the undershort. I find this short to be really, really comfortable. There's no front seam, so there's a little bit less riding when you're riding up on the court. And I also really find that it's a nice thick material, and I enjoy the pocket on the side. It does wide enough for like my keys or something if I'm running to my car, but I do still traditionally just throw the tennis ball underneath my short, but you could stick a tennis ball in there if you so chose. And next up, we've got a shoe. This is the K-Swiss Ultra Shot 3. This has been my favorite shoe for the year, my go-to. It has been very comfortable and stable, and it offering great durability, and I don't find it to be very heavy on court either. Just fits my wider foot well, is very comfortable, and my go-to when I'm not playtesting shoes. Last up, I have the Technifiber T-Rebound 298 EGA. This racket playtest really took me by surprise. This isn't necessarily a racket. I tend to gravitate toward control-oriented rackets, and this one was really powerful, but also controlled and lots of spin. I was really finding it to enhance my my serves, and I was still being able to play with variety. So great surprise for the playtest with this Technifiber. And that wraps it up for this week's vlog. Thanks for watching.